Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we are going to look at which Dataflow connector do you need to be using. And yes, there's more than one. Let's go look. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, Power BI Dataflows. Are you using them? If you are, inside a Power BI desktop, you may or may not have noticed that there's more than one connector for Dataflows as of the recording of this video, which is December 2021. At some point, this video may disappear because things may converge, but I want to give you the lay of the land as it is today. So enough of all the talking. Let's head over to my machine and take a look at what's going on. So I'm inside of the Power BI service inside my workspace demo 2, and I have a data flow here, just customers. And then if I go to AdventureWorks, I've got another data flow here, it's sales orders, but I'm going to really pay attention to this demo 2. When we go to get data, you're going to see Power BI data flows. And you would think that this is the one that I need to pick. It's going to connect to the service. If you haven't signed in already, it'll ask you to sign in, and we'll see the two data flows that I've got inside of Power BI. This is great. Adam, what's wrong with that? That's what I wanted. I want data flows. Ah, hang on. If you haven't been paying attention outside of Power BI, there is this thing called Dataverse. We're inside of the Power Apps portal. There's data flows there as well. So you can create data flows in more than just one spot. And we can see that we've got our products data flow here. So if I go back to Power BI desktop and I go get data, we'll go to more. Let's just search for data flows. And we'll see that there's two. One that says Power BI data flows and another one that just does data flows. Which one do I use? And really, I want to get to the Power Apps data Dataverse one, and it wasn't there in the Power BI data flows. So what do we do? I think you can probably already put this together, but let's look a little deeper. So if I choose data flows, not the Power BI data flows, you'll see something different here. We'll see workspaces, which is what we had before. This is the Power BI piece. And then we have environments, which is more of that Power Apps and Power Automate experience. And in here, we can see that we've got our products. So now we can see everything that's there from a Power Platform perspective. Now let's actually dig in a little deeper and see what the difference is between these two. So I already pulled in customer from Power BI and I pulled in product from the Power Apps Dataverse data flow. So what is the actual difference in the connector? So if we go into Power Query, let's look at product. We'll go to advanced editor and we can actually see that the connector here is powerplatform.dataflows. That is the connector. And if we go look at customer advanced editor, we see powerbi.dataflows. So this is how we can tell which one we're actually using. If you already have an existing data flow pulled in. I know that Power BI data flows is the default connector if you go to get data. At some point, I'm assuming that the Power BI data flows one is just going to go away and there won't be any confusion here. But I wanted to point this out because there is an actual difference here. So make sure you're using the latest connector, which is just data flows. All right, have you run into this yet? Were you confused? Did this help you? Let me know in the comments below. I want to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.